Hi folks, this is Zoltan from New Generation Hobbies, and today we are going to do an unboxing video of the brand new Fatshark Attitude V4 headset. We received this to our shop yesterday, and these just have been released by Fatshark. As you can see, the Attitude V4 comes in a tall box, just as we know from the last headsets. On the bottom of the box, we will find the model number, which is FSV1048. The specifications on the side of the box, we will see the package content. Now, the package contains an Attitude V4 headset. It has a 7.4 volts, 1000 milliamp lithium polymer battery. It has a 5.8 gigahertz 4-band RF module with OLED display, a Spironet circular polarized antenna, a zipper case, and I know from experience that it also has a charging cable with banana ends for the battery, and also has a 90 degree SMA connector. Now, obviously, we have the usual warnings of what to do and what not to do, and this is not a toy, shouldn't be used by kids under 14 years of age. We have some optional items which we can purchase separately for this, like diopter lenses, 1.3 GHz or 2.4 GHz RF modules, AV cable and data cable. Now, we know the specification is that there is an FOV 32 degrees diagonal, 58 to 72 IPD range, which can be adjusted. This goggle is based on two VGA 640 by 480 display modules. It has a built-in DVR, it has an NTSC and PAL auto selection, modular receiver bay, which will accept different modules specified in the optional thing, but it does come with a 5.8 GHz OLED receiver. It says it's included. It has a power consumption of 2.7 watts and it takes up to 13 volts input, so about 3 cell maximum. On this, it also says that it has a 3-axis head tracker, which is a mistake. I don't believe this one has a head tracker because the DVR function is on that button where usually the head tracker is supposed to be. So, opening the headset box, we will find that the goggles are in a tall zipper case. And under the zipper case, under the there is a second level, or the second shelf or something, where we can find a set of stickers, a QC card and the manual, and also the Velcro, which has to be plugged, put on the faceplate, a thin and a thick foam, and that's about it. So those, for your comfort, can be installed depending on how wide your face is. It can be installed on the faceplate, and that way making it comfortable to wear the goggles. Now, opening the zipper case, we can see the usual warning, and I'm sure that many of you guys already know about this, that exposing lens to the direct sunlight will result in LCD damage. What this really means is that if the sun shines in your lenses just for a split second, it's gonna bubble up the LCD and it's gonna create white dots on the screen. Now, that damage is not covered under warranty, so you will have to send it in for repair, and we will have to replace the LCDs if that occurs. So it's better off always handing off the goggles with the sun facing you, and when you take it off and you hand it over to somebody, put the head strap like that to cover the lenses, and now you can hand it off to somebody, right? Because this way it's covered, doesn't matter if the sun is behind you or in front of you, you will have protection against it. So opening the zipper case, we have the Spironet antenna, we have the cable, the banana charging cable I was talking about, and there is a 90 degree SMA connector. We have a red faceplate, 1000 milliamp battery. And I'm sure you guys know that the balancing lead on this one is not a balancing charging port, but it is a discharge port for the fan. on the faceplate. When you charge this, you charge it only to the main lead. You do not plug in the balancing port. And we have the goggles, right? The goggles are coming with this beautiful new red or maybe Bordeaux faceplate. There is a fat there is a shark on this one on this side, and there is a fat shark logo on the other side. It does come with the OLED display mounted in, and on the bottom you can find the IPD adjustment sliders. You can find the data cable input. On this end there is an a headset output. This is the RX on off switch on this side. I'm not sure how well the camera shows it, but this is the on off switch here. The OLED display has a button, control button, which I already reviewed in a separate video, so you can check that to see how that works. Brightness and contrast control on this side, and this is the DVR function on the other side. Also, we have the micro SD card slot where you can plug in the micro SD card for the DVR, and underneath there is a red LED. If that's on, that means that your DVR is operating. Now, as I can see, this goggle comes with a new faceplate. At least it looks like the faceplate design, it's fairly new or a bit different from the previous ones, because it does cover this area of the goggles. You see, on the previous ones, I think they just clicked in and there was no covering here or filling up there, which will make it a little bit more comfortable to wear, and it looks like it has a better nose relief as well. The receiver module, actually, it's way more sensitive than the previous receiver modules. So you gotta compare this to a LaForge or to a Trudy module, and this is gonna come up in par with those, even when those have the diversity module installed. This one barely lags behind in performance. And price-wise, obviously, this is gonna be way than less than half of the price of that. Now, there is one more thing to be mentioned on this one, that this is a limited edition. So it's not going to be available forever. There is only just a certain number of these goggles which are going to be made, and after that they're going to disappear from the market, just like the Dominator SE did last summer. So if you want one, just go ahead and order one as soon as possible so you can get one of this anniversary edition. Thank you.